Hello people, this is Shalini Singh from Tinkerly Jaipur. Since last days, I have been continuously getting emails of various people, various schools, and they are continuously asking me same question, how to do this documentation part. So I thought let's connect with you with a video where I will be explaining the entire journey of ATL documentation, what document we should get ready at back end, and how we should get the documentation process done. So let's start. As you all know, the recent list which has been issued by NITI Aayog is 60381. This list was issued in December 2019. And right now, the entire school which has been mentioned in this list, that is entire 6038 school, are required to do the documentation part. When I say of ATL journey, documentation is the most important part which every school should take care of, because our ATL grant depends on this part only. Right now, till yet you had done the registration part, now comes the actual go, where you have to give all supporting document related to your school, principal, ATL in charge, your PAN card, your bank account, everything. And once you get it done, you receive the government fund, and then you are able to just establish Atal Tinkering Lab in your school premises. So my this entire video, it can be divided into two part. In first part, I would be explaining the backend task which we have to do, that, or you can say the homework which NITI Aayog asked us to do. There are six homework which NITI Aayog has asked all school to do before setting for documentation. And in second part, I would be explaining step-by-step process of documentation, which link to follow, where to click, what information we have to give in each tab, everything. When I say documentation, the link which is used for documentation is aimapp2.aim.gov.in/atl_document_6038. So this is the link where you have to go. On this website, we have to complete the documentation part. Now, as I said, the first part, I would be discussing about the homework which NITI Aayog has asked you to do, or the backend task which we should be get ready of. The first thing which we have to get is official email ID detail. You should be ready with the official school email ID which was sent to you by GEM or by NITI Aayog during the time of registration, right? Second thing which has been asked by government or NITI Aayog is letter of principal or letter of space confirmation, or sometimes we say letter of declaration. It is nothing but a confirmation message where you ensure government, where you make government assured that you are using 1500 square feet of area of your school premises for lab. So its format can be downloaded from website as well, and you have to get it printed over school letterhead. Make sure each page of this has to be signed with principal or any head of school, and every page must contain stamp of that school, right? Again, you have to make sure you must have a PDF format of this, because while uploading the document, only PDF files are entertained. You won't be entertained with any Word file or any other format like PNG or something like that. Make sure you have only and only PDF formats. Next, and the third thing which is required is your bank passbook photograph, like PDF format. The details can be read from website, but again, I would like to mention, while opening a bank account for ATL fund, you have to make assured the bank has to be nationalized bank, and the account has to be opened in a format as per requirement by NITI Aayog. That is, suppose the name of school is ABC Public School. So while opening an account with nationalized bank, the account must be in name of ABC Public School - ATL grant, right? So what you have to do, you have to take a passbook photograph and get it converted into PDF, which would be helpful in uploading. The fourth thing which is required by NITI Aayog is Memorandum of Association. Again, the format is available on website. You have to get it downloaded, get it printed over a school letterhead, and each page of that should be signed by school principal or head of the school, and again it has to be in PDF format. Next, and the fifth thing which is asked by rules and regulation is lab layout. Here you have to give all the specification how you are going to use your 1500 square feet area. How many door it has, how many window it has, what's the ventilation processes, everything. It's nothing but a simple like layout. You have to make sketch on a paper giving like details of the area, and again you have to get it converted into PDF format. The sixth and the last thing which is asked by NITI Aayog is bond form. Bond form is only necessary in the case when school is private school. When school is government, there is no need of filling this bond form. In case of private school, they have to get this form downloaded, and while printing, you have to make sure you are printing this on 10 rupees stamp paper. Minimum 10 rupees stamp paper. It could be 20 rupees stamp paper. It could be 50 rupees stamp paper. But minimum 10 rupees stamp paper is must. The first page of bond form, the agreement, has to be printed on stamp, and the latter pages, the letter on, it can be followed by normal agreement page only. Again, each page of this has to be signed by principal or any head of the school, and it had to be properly stamped, and again you have to get ready with a proper PDF format. So these are the six documents which we have to get it done at the back end. Now, when you have all the six requirements fully done as per rules and regulation, as per norms, now you are ready for documentation part. So now I will be explaining step by step how to go ahead with documentation part. Right. So people, now for going ahead, we have to again go to the link. aim.aim.gov.in/ATL_document_6038. Now, as soon as you will click the link, the portal gets open, and now the first thing which you can see is UDISC code. UDISC code is nothing but when you are done with the registration part, it is provided by government only. So you have to fill that. Again, you have to give email ID, the official school email ID which was provided to you during the time of registration by GEM portal, right? Again, you have to give ATL unique code. ATL unique code, again, this was given to your school during the time of registration. So you can just note it from there. Now, you have to enter CAPTCHA code and again save. Once you are get it done with this, a new page opens. Now again, you have to fulfill some of the information. The first thing is unique code. Unique code you have. Second, UDISC code. Again, you have the idea. Third, school name. So, while entering school name, you have to be assured you are giving full school name which was given at the time of registration process. Here, the name should not differ. Make assure that, right? The next thing which has been asked is principal contact detail. You have to give your school principal contact detail. Now here the first is principal full name. You have to enter full name of principal, her mobile number, and while giving your mobile number, you make sure that mobile number which you are providing, that is linked by Aadhaar, right? Again, email ID, you have to enter principal email ID. Again, principal Aadhaar number, you have to give principal's Aadhaar number. Now, once you are done with this part, next question which is it's asking is ATL in charge detail. As you are aware, while in the ATL process involved the ATL in charge data also, in ATL in charge stuff too. So now, here you have to give the name of ATL in charge, full name of ATL in charge, mobile number, email ID. Once you have given all this information, you have to click on save button. Once we click on save, a new page get open, that is PFMS detail. PFMS, as the word sounds, is nothing big, but the bank detail, like the new ATL bank account detail you have to give, it's nothing like a, I often face lot of query, ma'am, what is this PFMS, how will we able to handle that? So it's nothing but account detail of the new ATL bank account, right? So you have to give, first of all, you have to enter your bank name, and as per norms, the ATL bank account which school open, always you have to get this done with the help of nationalized bank. No local banks are permitted, right? So you have to enter your bank name. Next is you have to enter bank IFSC code. Next you have to enter bank account number. While entering bank account number, confirm twice, right? Next thing which you have to enter is bank account holder name. And always the holder name is either, a holder is either principal or head of that school. So account has to be get opened with the name of principal or any head of that school. No teacher and no other members are allowed. Now, next is you have to upload bank passbook photograph. Again, the we have done in back end task only. You have to like take snap of first page of passbook, get it converted into PDF, and then you have to upload this file here. Now, the next point which we have to give information is space confirmation. Again, we have get its document ready in the back end. So, letter of proposal. The letter of proposal, letter of space confirmation, or the letter of declaration. We have the PDF file ready. We have to just upload over that and we have to click on save button. Now, once we click on save button, we have submit lab layout in PDF format only. Again, a new tab is showing space confirmation. There we have to give lab layout PDF. Again, we have ready the layout. We have to simply upload the PDF format of lab layout. Once we are done with this, click on save. Again, we have to upload MOA, that is Memorandum of Association. Just upload the agreement and click on save button. Now, we have to give PAN detail. Next step is PAN detail. In PAN detail, the first thing which it is asking is agency type. Here, agency type means what kind of school you have, whether you have private, you have semi-government, you have central government, you have state government, you have simply government school. So, you have to just choose what kind of school you have. That is agency type, sorry. So, next is registration number. Here, registration number simply means affiliation number. Like when a school say it is affiliated to CBSE, then they give you an affiliation number. So that number you have to enter here. Now, next step is date of registration. You have to mention the date on which the school was registered. The next point which it is asking is state of registration. It means in which state your school is. Next, principal Aadhaar number. Here you have to give your principal's Aadhaar number. Now, principal mobile number you have to enter. And if exempted from income tax, yes or no. You have to specify whether school is exempted from income tax. If yes, you have to click on yes. If no, you have to click on no. Now, submit form. Here you have to give the exemption certificate. Again, it should be in PDF format only. Now, next point is PAN number of school. You have to mention your school PAN number. And now, you again, the next step is upload PAN PDF. Here you have to upload PAN PDF format, right? Now, the next and the last step which you have to do is bond form. Again, government schools are not should not fill this form. This is only for private school. So private school, again, we have completed with the PDF. We have the PDF. What you have to do, you have to simply upload the bond form, the one which we have get it printed on stamp. So you have, and before uploading, kindly check all these documents twice or thrice so that we can avoid cancellation, right? So these, once you get upload all this document, you are done with the documentation part. In a short interval, you will be receiving a message or a mail from NITI Aayog, And I hope this was entire documentation process. I hope in a video I was able to explain, and this video was helpful enough to clear all your queries. And still you have doubt, you can mail me, you can reach me on mainly on mails. So Jai Hind, Jai Bharat. Thank you so much.